Hey, Star Trek fans, Dan Gunther here, bringing you my initial thoughts and review of the first episode of Season 3 of Star Trek Discovery, That Hope Is You. Before I really get into this, I do want to talk a little bit about our live show that we normally do on Fridays at 9 p.m. Eastern, 6 p.m. Pacific. Unfortunately, I've recently learned that when international audiences get the show, specifically Canadians watching on Crave TV, they get the show at that exact time. That's when it drops in Canada. So we've decided to move our live show a day later to Saturday. Hopefully that doesn't inconvenience too many of you. I know that it will be good news for a few people who watch on Crave and possibly Netflix. I'm not sure when it drops on Netflix internationally, but hopefully that will allow more people to join us and talk about the episode. So on to the discussion about this episode. At the end of Season 2, of course, Discovery was catapulted through the wormhole following Burnham in the Red Angel suit to the 32nd century to hide the sphere data from Control, who was going to use it to destroy all life in the galaxy. At the start of this episode, we get Burnham coming through the wormhole and crashing with David Ajala's character's ship, and they crash on a planet that is not Terra Elysium, as Burnham had hoped. However, it appears that their overall mission to protect all life in the galaxy and prevent it from being destroyed is a success. And the first thing I want to call out in this episode is Sinequa Martin-Green's acting. Just incredible. I love the elation mixed with the kind of despair that she's all alone when she, of course, sends the Red Angel suit back, and that kind of despair that she holds on to because she's given up everything that she knows and loves and doesn't know if Discovery is okay, can't contact them. You know, her acting throughout this episode is just incredible. I've always liked Sinequa Martin-Green. I thought she's been a strong actor as Burnham throughout the series, but this episode is really next level and really showcases some of her terrific acting chops. Everything from, like I say, her reactions here at the start of the episode to her being drugged and her kind of stream of consciousness thought as she's responding to this drug and talking about the mission she's been on and all this stuff. Just really great acting. I really, really admired her in this episode. Through Burnham's eyes, we get a glimpse of the year 3188, the year that she's landed in, and it's far beyond anything we've ever seen in Star Trek before, beyond the time cops that we saw in Star Trek Voyager, and yes, even beyond Daniel's temporal agents from the temporal Cold War that we saw in Enterprise. Speaking of the temporal war, it gets a name drop here. Apparently, after the temporal wars, all of the time travel equipment was banned and destroyed, and there's no remnant of it whatsoever anymore, so time travel is something that's not a day-to-day occurrence in this timeline now. So I thought that was interesting. I was curious how they were going to handle that, given that we know that time travel technology is so prevalent just a couple centuries before this time period. The episode plays out mostly as a two-person play. We get Cleveland Book as he's colloquially known as, who he and Burnham initially come to blows. They don't trust each other, but over the course of the episode we learn that he's one of the good guys. I love that he's a conservationist. That's a really interesting character that we've never seen in Star Trek before, protecting endangered species in this new world where the Federation doesn't have a huge presence. I thought that was a really interesting take, and I'm curious about this kind of tie that he has to nature. I'm wondering if that will get explained more in coming episodes, or if that's just kind of a mysterious aspect of his character that won't get any real depth looked into it. Personally, I hope not. I hope they get into it and kind of explain what this is all about and what it really ultimately means. Incredible performance by this guy. I love his kind of, cheekiness, I guess. He's definitely very charming. I really like that he's such a charmer and just kind of going with the flow, but at the core, a really good character and a good person. What was really interesting about the episode, of course, is that we don't see the Discovery at all. It's all from Burnham's perspective, which honestly I thought was interesting. We're kind of left with the question of where is the Discovery? Where has she appeared, or has she not, just not appeared yet? Did they make it to that planet, Terra Elysium, that they were trying to get to? The episode leaves that question up in the air, and I think that's an interesting mystery, which I think, from what I've seen, I think we get answers to that in the next episode. The other major character in the story, of course, is the guy that we see at the very beginning of the episode and in the final scene, which is this Federation officer who's not really an officer, who's been manning this Federation post for 40 years. And I love the universe through this guy's eyes. He's maintaining this watch here, this hope that someone will come through the door someday, and it eventually happens. It's Burnham. And I love the hope that's personified through him. And I think, you know, it's very lucky that Burnham found Book, who's, like I said, a good guy in kind of what seems to be a galaxy of not so good guys. And of course, the Federation official, who is not a commissioned officer, but Burnham commissions him as an officer at the end so he can hang the Federation flag. I thought that was a really beautiful and touching scene. His optimism is really great and gives me a lot of hope for what we're going to see through this season. Like some other people, I was definitely kind of worried that the season would be very bleak and without hope, and like the Federation's gone and, you know, all this badness has happened. But, you know, with these characters that we see in this episode, that hope really shines through, and I really think they're going to tell a really interesting story about bringing the Federation back together, you know. And like Burnham and this gentleman here at the Federation outpost, I think it's very possible. I see the optimism in their faces, and I think it can be done. So, and of course, you know, over the course of this season, we'll see how that happens, likely through the efforts of the crew of the Discovery jumping around with their spore drive. That's kind of my guess as to where this is all headed. So, yeah, very much a strong start to the season. If nothing else, what it did was made me very excited to see what's to come. We, of course, get lots of references, which I will detail in my Disco Deep Dive video coming later. And yeah, hopefully you can join us on Saturday for our live shows. Me and Brandy will be talking about this premiere episode, and we would really hope that you would all join us. So thank you all so much for watching this week, and thank you to the Patreon supporters for their help in bringing these episodes to you. I really do appreciate it and couldn't do it without your help. Thank you to everyone else for liking, sharing, and subscribing, and like I said, just watching. That's really the best thing you can do for the channel, and I do appreciate that. So I will see you all in the next video, and until then, as always, live long and prosper.